Hi, assalamualaikum everybody. This is tutorial 06 and in this video I'm going to cover tutorial for chapter 5, the second law of thermodynamics, part A, heat engine, refrigerator and heat pump. Question number 1. A steam power plant receives heat from a furnace at a rate of 300 gigajoule per hour. If the waste heat is transferred to the cooling water at a rate of 150 gigajoule per hour, determine the net power output and thermal efficiency of this power plant. In this question, we have a steam power plant in which it is heat engine, and this steam power plant will receive heat from furnace at the rate of 300 gigajoule per hour, means that it is QH. Then the heat will be waste into cooling water at rate of 150 gigajoule per hour, means that it is QL. First, we need to find the net power output, which is W out. From the energy balance from this heat engine, we can deduce QH is equal to W out plus QL. This is input and this is output. We want to find the W out, so we can rearrange this equation until we get this. Because we are given with QH also QL, we just substitute in like this. So we solve and we get the W out is equal to 150 gigajoule per hour. Next, we need to find the thermal efficiency, in which the equation for thermal efficiency for heat engine is W out over QH. QH we have here 300 gigajoule per hour, and W we have found just now, so we just substitute into this equation, so we will get 0.5 efficiency. So that is how we solve question number 1. Next, question number 2. A Carnot heat engine receives 700 kilojoule of steam from a heat source of unknown temperature and rejects 300 kilojoule of it to a heat sink at temperature 24 degrees C. Determine the temperature of the heat source and thermal efficiency of the heat engine. In this question, we have a Carnot heat engine in which it receives heat which is 700 kilojoules from heat source, and it releases heat to the heat sink in amount of 300 kilojoules. We are given with the temperature for heat sink which is 24 degrees C, and now we have to find the temperature of heat source which is TH, and also the thermal efficiency for this heat engine. We know that this heat engine is reversible, so because of it is reversible, so we can use this temperature scale. So in this scale, we can relate the QH, the QL, TL and also TH. So we want to find the TH because we are given with QH, QL and also TL. So we can find the TH by using this equation. So after we rearrange, we will get this, and we substitute all the QH, QL and also TL into this equation, then we will get the answer for TH is equal to 693 Kelvin. Before we forget, this temperature scale we should use in Kelvin. So that is why we have to change from degree C to Kelvin first. Then after that, we proceed with calculation. Next, the thermal efficiency. In order to calculate the thermal efficiency, we can use this equation, 1 minus TL over TH. TL is given, and TH we have already found before, and we substitute into this equation, then we solve and we get 0.571. So that is how we solve question number 2. Next, question number 3. Trifluoroethane enters the condenser of a residential heat pump at known pressure and temperature of 800 kPa and 35 degrees C respectively at mass flow rate of 0.02 kg/s. The tetrafluoroethane later leaves the condenser at the state of saturated liquid and at constant pressure of 800 kPa. It is also known that the compressor of this heat pump consumes power of 1.5 kW. Determine the coefficient of performance of heat pump and calculate the rate of heat absorption from the outside air. In this question, all the occurrence happen in the heat pump. Basically, for heat pump, it is included four different equipment. And for heat pump, the QL will be transferred in and it will release QH into the hot space. And in order to operate this heat pump, power is needed. So if you look in this figure, when we magnify this figure, it will become like this. We have four different equipment, and that consists of condenser, compressor, evaporator and also the throttling valve. So the problem in this question is happening in this condenser, in which if we look at the condenser, the refrigerant will enter the condenser at 800 kPa and 35 degrees C. Then it will leave the condenser at constant pressure, which is 800 kPa, in saturated liquid phase. Other than the refrigerant that will leave the condenser, the QH will also leave the condenser. So in order to find the COP for heat pump, we have to use this equation, which is QH over Win. Win is already given, which is 1.5 kilowatt, but we have to find what is the QH. So if you look at the condenser, we can find the QH from this condenser. By referring the first law of thermodynamics for open system at the condenser only, we can simplify this equation after we neglect the unnecessary, which is PE, KE and also W. Even though in this question W is given, but this W is not at the condenser. As I mentioned just now, this first law of thermodynamics for open system, we have to consider only at the condenser so that we can find the QH. So now, after we simplify this equation, we will get negative QH is equal to MH2 minus H1. Other than this, we can also consider on the energy balance at this condenser, in which we will get MH1 is equal to MH2 plus QH. This is the inlet and this is the outlet, in which the outlet from this condenser is MH2 and also QH. So then, in order to find the QH, we have to find first the H2 and also H1. H1 is H at the entrance, H2 is the H at the exit of the condenser. At point 1, the refrigerant enter the condenser at 800 kilopascal and 35 degrees C. So before we can get what is the H1, we need to find first what is the phase at state 1. After we consider 800 kilopascal and 35 degrees C, and we have found that the phase at this state 1 is superheated. So we go to table A13 and we can find the H at 800 kilopascal and 35 degrees C from interpolation, and we will get the H1 is equal to 271.22 kilojoule per kg. Next, at point 2, the refrigerant leaves the condenser at 800 kilopascal in saturated liquid phase. So because of it is saturated liquid phase, we just find the H2 at table A12, and H2 is equal to HF at 800 kilopascal, and H2 is equal to 95.47 kilojoule per kg. So now we have found the H2 and also the H1. We can substitute this H1 and also H2 inside this equation, and M is already given, which is 0.02 kg per second. After we solve, we will get the answer for QH is equal to 3.515 kilowatt. So from this QH, we can substitute into this COP equation, and Win is already given, which is 1.5 kilowatt. So after we solve, we will get the COP is equal to 2.34. So that's how we find the COP by using this relation. Next, we have to find the rate of heat absorption from the outside air. Means that we have to find the QL. So in order to find the QL, we have to consider the energy balance at the whole heat pump. So it is equal to QL plus Win is equal to QH. After we rearrange, we can get the QL, which is QL is equal to QH minus Win. QH we have already found before, which is 3.515 kilowatt, and the Win is already given, which is 1.5 kilowatt. So we substitute in, then we will get 2.02 kilowatt. So this is how we solve question number 3. Next, question number 4. A heat engine is operates between a heat source at temperature 500 degrees C and heat sink at temperature 30 degrees C. Heat is applied to the heat engine at a steady rate of 1300 kilojoule per minute. Determine the Carnot efficiency of this heat engine and calculate the maximum power output for this heat engine. In this question, we have heat engine. 1300 kilojoule per minute will be supplied from the heat source at temperature of 500 degrees C, producing power, and some of the heat will release at heat sink at temperature 30 degrees C. So we need to find the thermal efficiency and also the power output. From the question, we have to find the Carnot efficiency, in which the efficiency for reversible heat engine. So means that because we are given with TH and also TL, we can find the thermal efficiency is equal to 1 minus TL over TH. So TH is 500 degrees C and TL is 30 degrees C. And before we can substitute into this, we have to convert the degrees C into Kelvin first. Then after that, we can substitute into this equation. After we substitute, we will get this. Then we solve, we will get 0.608. So this is the Carnot efficiency. Next, we have to find the W out. From the thermal efficiency equation, we can get the relationship of W out and also QH. Because we want to find the W out, we can rearrange this equation until we get this. The thermal efficiency we have found before, which is 0.608, and the QH is given, which is 1300 kJ per minute. We substitute in, then we will get the W out is equal to 790.4 kJ per minute or 13.1 kilowatt. So that's how we solve question number 4. Question number 5. A Carnot refrigerator operates in a room in which the temperature is 25 degrees C. The refrigerator consumes 500 watt of power when operating and has a COP of 4.5. Determine A, the rate of heat removal from the refrigerated space, B, the temperature of the refrigerated space. In this question, we have refrigerator where it consumes 500 watt and produce COP of 4.5. So for question A, we need to find the QL, and for question B, we need to find TL. For question A, we need to find QL, and we are given with COP, which is 4.5. When we look at the equation for COP, we can have the relation of QL. So by using this equation, we can find the QL. After we rearrange, we will get QL is equal to COP multiplied with W in. COP is given 4.5, W in is also given 500 watt. After we substitute and we solve, we will get 2.25 kilowatt or 135 kilojoule per minute. Next, B, we need to find TL. Because we are given with COP and this refrigerator is Carnot, we can use the COP for Carnot refrigerator equation in order to find TL. So the equation is 1 over TH over TL minus 1. TH is already given and we want to find the TL. So after we substitute COP and also TH, and we rearrange until we get TL, we will get TL is equal to 243.8 Kelvin or negative 29.2 degrees C. So that is how we solve question number 5. So we have finished all the questions for part A. Till we meet again, thank you and assalamualaikum.